This is a lecture on two particular values of resistance, a short circuit and an open circuit. Short circuits ideally have resistances of 0 ohms, so remembering that resistance is opposition to DC current flow, this means that a short has absolutely no resistance to that current flow. And examples of shorts are leads like this that we use in labs to connect components together, and copper traces on printed circuit boards that connect circuit elements together. Now, like any element, a short is defined by its voltage-current relationship, and that voltage-current relationship is that there's 0 volts across a short no matter what the current flowing through the short is. So there could be a little bit of current or a whole lot of current, and ideally there's 0 volts across that short. Now you can see this relationship right from Ohm's law. We know from Ohm's law that voltage is resistance times current, and since a short has 0 ohms, well, it doesn't matter what this I value is. Since R is 0, our voltage is going to be 0. Now an open circuit, that's the other end of the spectrum of resistance. Ideally, an open circuit has infinite resistance. So examples of open circuits are disconnects, like broken wires or lifted traces on a printed circuit board. And the current voltage relationship for an open is that there's 0 current for an open for any voltage across that open. So there could be a little voltage or a whole lot of voltage across that open, and ideally the current for the open is 0. And the easiest way to reason this is that if you remember back to a previous lecture, we talked about how there's 2 conditions for current to flow. An energy source is one condition, and then the other condition is a closed path. So by the very definition of an open being a disconnect, you don't have a closed path, therefore no current can flow. Now if we look at this diagram here, what this shows is a 12-volt source connected right across a resistor. So these lines that you see in diagrams, those represent shorts. So we now know that across each one of these connections here, up at the top, as well as the bottom here, there's 0 volts across those shorts, no matter what this current flowing in the circuit is. Okay, I mean, this could be a little current, a whole lot of current, and again, there's going to be ideally 0 volts across those shorts that connect the elements together. Well, what this means is that since there's 0 volts across these connections, that means that this resistor ideally is going to have the same voltage as the voltage source. Okay, because nothing changes in voltage as we go from one end of the short to the other end of the short. Now, this is all ideal. I mean, in reality, you know, those wires and those traces, they have some resistance, you know, typically very small, and, you know, typically you'll have a very small amount of voltage that's dropped across a trace or a wire. So, you know, if you were in a lab and you had a voltmeter, okay, a voltmeter is a piece of equipment that will display how many volts is across something that you connect it to. Well, if our source was exactly 12 volts, and you took your voltmeter and put it over here across the resistor on the other end of the leads where the source is, well, you might read 11.998 volts. You know, there may be 2 millivolts dropped across these connections. Okay, but when we're doing circuit analysis, you know, we're not going to worry about, you know, the small amount of voltage that's you know, across non-ideal wires. We just consider the wires or the traces that are connecting the elements to be ideal. Now here's another diagram, and we did this problem just in the previous lecture where we used Ohm's law to find that there's 20 volts across this 10k ohm resistor since there's 2 milliamps flowing through it. Well, same thing, since there's 0 volts across both these connections here, these wires, there's also 20 volts across our current source. Okay, so this 2 milliamp current source would have 20 volts across it, just like the resistor does. And again, that's because there's 0 volts across these shorts. So one reason, or you know, typically what you'll see a lot of times in diagrams is that you'll see rectangles drawn. Okay, because remember, these connection points are called nodes. Okay, so often you'll see nodes drawn like this with rectangles over where the shorts are. And you see that's because all along the short, the voltage is the same, right? Because again, there's 0 volts across. So that's sort of just a pictorial way to show that this piece of wire, or this line that represents a wire or a trace, has the same voltage all along it. Okay, so this node has the same voltage. There's 12 volts across here and here on the node. There's 12 volts across here and here on the node. There's 12 volts across here and here on the node. There's 20 volts across here to here. There's 20 volts across here to here, and so on, because you don't lose any voltage as you go along the shorts. Okay? Now in open, and here's a diagram with an open. So this is our symbol, circuit symbol. Oops. Okay, over here. This is our circuit symbol for an open. It's just two circles separated by a gap that indicates a disconnect. So remember, the current voltage definition of an open is that you have zero current no matter what the voltage is. And a lot of times students have difficulty with, or you know, they just think, well, if there's zero current for the open, the voltage across it must be zero. How can you have voltage across an open if there's no current? Well, let's look at this here. Let's say this bottom node, okay, this bottom connection point here, let's say it had some voltage V. In a later class, we'll learn that often in a circuit like this, we'll define this side of the voltage source, the negative terminal, as what we call electrical ground. And at electrical ground, we define the voltage to be zero. Okay, but that's for a later class. I mean, right now we're just gonna say it's some voltage V. Well, if this node here is some voltage V, this node, okay, which is the left side of the open that's connected to the higher end side of the 12 volts, well, this node would have 12 plus V, okay, because there's 12 volts across this voltage source. And remember, this voltage is a difference, right? It tells us the difference of voltage between both ends of that voltage source. So if there's V volts here, this end of the voltage source must be 12 plus that, okay? Or another way to look at it as it is, as I go from the lower end of the voltage source to the higher end of the voltage source, I'm increasing this amount. So I'm V here, and I'm going to increase 12 volts when I get to this side of the voltage source. So this node here would have 12 plus V volts. Now, on the other side of the open, the right side of the open, that's the top side of this resistor. But look, this resistor would have zero current. There's no current flowing here. Actually, probably putting the arrow there is kind of deceiving, because there's nothing flowing, so there's no reason to put a direction. See, there's no current in this resistor because of this broken path, because of this open. So if you look at Ohm's law for the resistor, right, voltage is resistance times current. Well, the current is zero. Therefore, the voltage across the resistor is zero. See, if you have zero current through a resistor, it has 0 volts across it, just like a short does. I mean, for a different reason, though, because here it's because the I is zero, not because the R is zero. But still, 0 volts across something, whether it's a short or whether it's an element like a resistor that has no current through it, means that voltage is the same on both sides. So if there's V on this side of the resistor and there's 0 volts across it, I have V on the other side of the resistor. So you see there's 12 plus V volts on this side of the open, there's V volts on this side of the open. So the voltage across the open would be 12 plus V minus V, right? Because voltage across something is a difference. So you see the V's cancel out, and you have 12 volts across that open. You get the full amount of source voltage across that open, even though there's zero current flowing through it. And, you know, a common, well, hopefully not common, but I mean a situation that this ties to is that, you know, if you think of this source as being representative of, you know, a power company, and this resistor here being representative of, say, you know, some residence where you have various, you know, electronic and electrical equipment that you're running, you know, household appliances or whatever it may be. And then these lines representing cables that connect the power company to your place of residence. Well, if a power cable breaks, like say there's a storm in your neighborhood and a power cable breaks and, you know, it falls to the ground. So that would be an open. Okay, that's a disconnect. Well, you know, would you go over there and pick up those cables? And, you know, of course you wouldn't, right? Because, you know, if that were to happen, if someone were to pick up those cables, well, look what happens. They complete the circuit, and now current would flow in the circuit, right? And it would flow through that person. And, you know, that's how people get seriously hurt. That's how people get, you know, electrocuted. So it's not until, you know, the power company turns off the source, you know, makes this 0 volts, you know, turns off the source, that, you know, someone would go out there, like a repairman or a repair person, and actually, you know, fix the broken cable. So the big point here is that even though there's zero current for an open, there can be voltage across it. And in fact, any amount of voltage, ideally you would still have 0 current for that open.